Hello, hello, YouTube viewers. This is Blake Fannin. Please like, share, and subscribe. Listen. When I have gone even just a few days without praying or reading my Bible, I tend to cuss. I tend to think about things that I shouldn't, and I tend to lose my temper more than usual, when something or someone offends me, ticks me off, or makes me mad. But listen, just because sometimes we cuss and say things and do things and think about things that we shouldn't, that does not mean we have lost our salvation. The Bible says, the Lord will never leave us nor forsake us. The Bible says in 1 John 1:9, if we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. John 3:16 says, for God so loved the world that he sent His only begotten Son, that whosoever should believe on Him would not perish, but have eternal life. Mark 11 says, before you pray, first forgive anyone you are holding a grudge against, so that your prayers may be answered. So right now, under the authority of Jesus' name, I loose and forgive anyone who's offended me, no matter who they are. I loose and forgive anyone who's offended or ticked me off or made me mad or got on my nerves, no matter how mad they've made me or how irritated or upset I've been at them. I loose and forgive anyone in my family or in my friend circle who has offended me, ticked me off, worried me, got on my nerves, or made me mad. In Jesus' name. Mark 11 says, ask and you shall receive, and if you have faith as small as a grain of mustard seed, you can command any kind of a mountain to move. So right now, under the authority of Jesus' name, I command hard hearts to be softened, anger, hatred, bitterness, unforgiveness, and forgetfulness to go into the pit of hell and stay there. The Bible says, what you bind on earth, it is bound in heaven, and what you loose on earth, it is loosed in heaven. I empower and loose Michael and the angelic armies to war for the souls of these who watch this video and all the other videos of this kind that I've done. In Jesus' name. Now, YouTube viewers, listen, if you will read in the books of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, you will see that Jesus Christ Himself came to this earth to die for you. In those four books in the Bible, you will see that Jesus, the only begotten Son of the Highest, was sent to this earth to die for you and I. The King of Kings and Lord of Lords, Jesus, He came to this earth. Jesus, the King of Kings, came to this earth to die for you. Are you hearing me? Jesus, who the Bible calls in Revelation the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. That is who Jesus is. And yet, one second, Alexa, stop. And yet, even though he is the Lord and King of all, he was sent to this earth to die for you. He was sent to this earth to die for all who are lost, to die for all who have not, who have done wrong. The Bible says in 1 John 1:9, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. But if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us and to cleanse us of all unrighteousness. So, that is why Jesus, the King of Kings and Lord of all Lords, came to this earth to die for those who have never had a chance of eternal life. Now, listen. Christmas is over. This is January 2nd of 2019, or 2019, but the reason we celebrate Christmas is because that is the time, that is the appointed time that we celebrate Jesus' birth. It may not be the time that he was born, but that is why we celebrate Christmas, because of his birth. Now listen, Jesus died to save you from sin. He died to heal your body. Mark 16 says those who believe in him can lay hands on the sick and see the sick healed. Jesus came to this earth and died to see you saved, healed, set free, and delivered. The gift of salvation is free. There is no charge to us, but Jesus had to pay the price of his own life. Jesus had to pay the price of his own life so we could have eternal life. He had to die so that we could live. But he was raised from the dead 3 days later. 3 days after being put in the grave, he was raised to eternal life. His resurrection is the reason we celebrate Easter. So, YouTube viewers, let me ask you one second. Let me ask you this. If you had since you have such a wonderful, wonderful opportunity to ask Jesus into your heart, since you now have in front of you the opportunity to ask Jesus into your heart, why wouldn't you do that? He said he came that we may have life and have it more abundantly. Why don't you want to accept his free gift of salvation and eternal life and love? Now, YouTube viewers, one second. Lord, may I finish this video the way I had planned. Okay, thank you. Thank you. YouTube viewers, you may think or wonder, don't I have to give up smoking, pornography, or drugs or other bad things that I've done before I can ask him into my heart? No. He says, come just as you are. He says, come just as you are. He wants you to come to him first, and then he will help you clean your life up. He wants you to come to him first. He says, come unto me first, and then I will help you clean your life up. You have to ask him into your heart and life. That is how you get saved, by asking Jesus. You have to ask Jesus to come into your heart and life. You just say, Jesus, I confess that I've said and done and thought about things that I shouldn't have. I thank you for dying for me. I confess that I've done wrong. I ask you to come into my heart. I make you my Lord and Savior and best friend forever. In your precious name, amen. YouTube viewers, that's what you have to do. You have to confess that you have said, done, and thought about things that you shouldn't have, and then you have to ask Jesus to come and live inside of you. You have to ask Jesus to come and live, to come in and live inside of your heart, and he will. So, if you'd like to, please repeat after me. Dear Jesus, I confess that I've done, said, and thought about things that I shouldn't have. I ask you to forgive me of all that I've done wrong. Jesus, I ask you to come into my heart. Jesus, I ask you to come into my heart and be my Lord, Savior, and best friend forever. I ask this in your precious name. Jesus, amen. YouTube viewers, if you did that, if you just asked Jesus into your heart, if you asked Jesus into your heart just then, please let me know in the comments below. And then, please like, share, and subscribe.